whenever it's possible for me to try and, whenever it's possible for me to do things along body contours, along her body lines, it's always preferable. This for me is non-diagnostic. She says, my low back is hurting me. I still need to figure out what's happening with the segments here, what's happening with her sacrum, and something specific I might change. This is something non-specific. This is the first time I'm getting her on the table, and again, she doesn't know who I am. Maybe someone did something, told her to relax, and then did something she didn't like. So I tell her, I say this to all my patients, except movies. I say, I'm not going to do anything sudden or unexpected. If I do anything that's uncomfortable, you tell me, and I will slow down. And I need them to hear it, and they all go, So I'm going to put one hand here, and you can see I can hold a basketball with one hand, with these big hands. So this is almost her whole back. Okay, so it's very easy for me to get some easy sensations here. I'm going to lean into her, my body weight, and then push. But I'm not rolling, I'm not sliding on the tissue. This is massage, this is not what I'm doing. And when I say massage, I don't mean that as a bad word. Massage is fine, but massage feels good, but it's not going to treat, it's not going to break bonds. Everything I'm trying to do is break bonds that shouldn't be there. So her erector spinae muscles are quite large. In the cadaver, it's big. So I'm gonna put my hands here, sink into her, and move lateral. The bonds break when you hold it. So again, if I have 30 seconds, I would rather do this two or three times, good, than go, this is not more, this is not better. It's not better. You have to, I'm asking you to believe me on that. It's not better. But the patient will say, oh, I like that, do that. They don't know anything.
You go to the masseuse.
Yeah, go to the masseuse. Okay, the patient does not know how to, you know, patients come to you and they have a pain. Has this ever happened to you? Right here, oh, right there, right there.
Push.
Touch that. If touching that and rubbing that was going to make it go away, they wouldn't be in your office already. Someone else did this and it didn't work. So I ask her only to tell me when it's too painful. So you have to use your body weight, sink into her, and then start to go lateral and let all your fingers touch. As long as I am in an appropriate area, I'm not in an area that's going to make her upset or sexual, put your hands here. This is better than this. You're going to get more technique with your hands laying down. So I lay down, I lean out, and this is where the stretch happens. And then I slowly come off, I move up, lean down. I do this a little bit, and then I walk around the table, I do it the other side. Another way to do this that I like to do is to put this hand over this thumb. It makes it feel more even to me. And here's her spinous process here. I'm not on her spinous process. Down and out. This is a conversation you're having with them. You're finding out what her barriers are. She's finding out who you are. And when I say slow on and slow off, this is what I call slow. I'm not doing this. This it's a very small mental thing. When you're off, there's a part of her that doesn't know where you are. It's afraid. She's upside down, where are you? So I'm always touching, I'm always there. I walk around the table, I walk around like this. Small thing. Whatever I can do that is to my advantage, I do. So once in a while, I'll do this too. I just keep picking on you because you're a big guy. I'll get a big guy and I say, oh, I can do this strong. And I go, boom, and oh, it's too much. And that's my mistake because I am thinking, I'm not feeling. I look at him and I think, I can do what I want. And sometimes you can't. So I come here and then I fall into her. And then I take her to the barrier and then come off, and then I move up, fall in, and I never leave her shirt. I will stay just on the outside and go all the way up, and I'll move this hand. And I want to show you a